What's up, everybody? In today's video, we're going to talk about a concept that tends to trip up newer programmers, and that is arrays. All that an array is a list with a fixed size. So for example, let's say that you have an array that contains exactly 7 integers, or maybe it contains 5 Apple objects, or 12 strings. Arrays are used all the time in code and are a really powerful feature of the language. So let's get into a few examples of actually using arrays and showing how we use them in day-to-day code. All right, I've got the IntelliJ IDE up. I'm gonna select new project. We're gonna call this arrays, put it in the code directory, and we're gonna add sample code. All right, now I'm gonna go into the main class that IntelliJ generated for us. I'm gonna delete the hello world. Now what we're going to do is we're going to make a program that adds up a set of integers and returns the sum. So what we'll do is we'll make a variable called sum. We'll print out the sum. Now we need to figure out how to set the sum. We'll have a function that does that for us. Well, it'll return nothing for now, just to make sure that there's nothing going on weird with this code. We'll run it and make sure that it's doing everything we expect so far. As we expect, the sum is currently 0 because we're returning 0 in this sum function, and then we're setting that to the sum variable and printing it out. Let's make this a little more interesting, and we'll say num1 equals 2 and num2 equals 9. Now let's pass in num1 and num2 into our function. Now we will return the sum. And we will verify this works as expected. All right, cool, so that's working as expected. Now let's say I want to have another function that takes a sum of 3 numbers. Now I want my sum of all 3 numbers. You'll notice here that I'm passing in 3 parameters instead of 2, so the IDE doesn't know what this sum function is. So I actually have to make a very similar function that now takes 3 arguments. Let's run this, make sure this works. And whoops, I forgot to print out the result of sum2. I'll fix that.
Come on, man.
Sum2? Okay, now we'll run it. All right, so our program is working as expected. That's fine, but what if we wanted to extend this? Let's say I want to take the sum of not 2, not 3 numbers, but 23 numbers. Ugh, that gets really gross because now I have to pass in 23 integers into my sum function.
Yeah, no kidding.
Well, some of you might be thinking, no, you don't. All you have to do is take the sum of 3 at a time or of 5 at a time. That could work, but there's a much better way to do it. And one such method to do that is with arrays. So what I'm going to do is instead of an integer pointing to a single integer, I'm going to make an array of integers. So again, when I talk about an array, what I'm talking about is a list with a fixed length. So the way that you do that syntactically in Java is you add these square brackets, and just like any other variable, you know, you give it a name, numArray, and we're gonna set it equal to a set of numbers. All right, that's all there is to it. We just made an integer array called numArray with 4 values in it. This doesn't have to be sequential numbers. This could be a 9. This could be a 13. Doesn't matter. As long as those are integers, then this points back to the integer array definition we gave right here. Now let's go ahead and update our sum function to take a numArray. So let's say I remove these 2 variables and I remove this code. Now I want sum to take numArray. Okay, so it's complaining because it doesn't know what the sum taking in an integer array method is. So I need to change my method declaration to take in an integer array. I'll also call this numArray. And also now I don't need this function either. Boom. Okay. Now, how do I actually do stuff with my array? Well, okay, let's figure that out. Just to make the IDE happy here for a second, let's call this 0. Now that I've got this array in my function, how do I get the values out of it so that I can compute their collective sum? Let's say that I want to get this 9 right here. Let's try doing what's called getting an array via its index. I'm gonna look in numArray. The square brackets operator on an array says, let me get something out of my array. Let's get the first element. Let's see what this prints. Oh, that's weird. It gave me 2, but I thought 2 was the second element. Java and a lot of other languages start with 0 as the very first index within an array. So this is going to be position 0. This is position 1, 2, 3, and so on. So what I actually want to do, if I want to get 9, is I want to use index 0. And there it is. I've got 9. All right, so now that we know how to get a value out of our array, aka via the index, one way that we could solve our problem, we could do numArray 0 plus numArray 1, numArray 2, and numArray 3. Let's see if this works. All right, this code looks to be working as expected. The first element is 9. And the sum of the 4 elements it's saying is 28. That's 9 plus 2 is 11, plus 13 is 24, plus 4 is 28. Great. But you may be thinking, this is still a little error prone. The numArray here has exactly 4 elements. Let's say that it had 6 elements. All I would be doing is adding the first 4 elements in this function. What if it only had 2 elements? Now, what would be numArray 2 and numArray 3? Well, that's actually an error case in Java called an array index out of bounds exception that we can go into later. Point being, this code is still error prone. We need to figure out a way to look through the entire array without going too far or not far enough. So there are a few ways we can do that. We'll go ahead first and we will do it with a while loop. So I'm going to have a sum variable, and I'm going to return the sum variable. Now what we're going to do is we're going to have an index. We're going to say while the index is less than numArray.length. NumArray.length equals the number of elements in our array. So this should return 4. We're going to make index itself plus 1. So what this is going to do is it's going to say, starting at 0, as long as I'm less than numArray.length, I'm going to keep adding index over and over again. Let's print out the value of index just to make sure that this looks like it should be correct. All right, so you can see this prints out 0, 1, 2, and 3. That looks awfully familiar from the return statement we had previously, right? So now what we can do is we can say that sum equals the current sum plus numArray at index. So what we're doing here is we're collectively adding to the variable sum with the current value in numArray at index. Let's make sure this works. Perfect. The sum is 28. Now, let's say that it's 28 right now. And I add a 5th element, this should make it 38. See, arrays are great. Now what we've done is we've simplified something that was going to have to be multiple methods and really complicated to understand how many parameters are passed in to a single method that smartly iterates over all of them and then sums them up. This is awesome. Let's keep going further. Let's make this code a little bit better. One thing we can do to clean this code up is we can use a different looping mechanism. There is something that initializes a variable, checks to see if the variable meets a condition, and then mutates the variable. And that is called a for loop. So instead of a while loop, now we're going to use a for loop. And a for loop has three main conditions. First, you define an index or some sort of incrementer, some sort of counter, something like that. I already defined index up here, so I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this. And then now I'm going to add the third parameter, which is going to be how the index changes over time. And one way that we often shorthand index equals index plus one is we actually do what's called index plus plus. This is short for take the current value of index and add one to it. So I'm going to go ahead and do that in the for loop. Now let's run this and make sure that it works. All right, sum is 38, even less code now. We initialize our index variable, we verify that our index is less than the array length, and then we increment it. So this code is doing the equivalent of what we just did in our while loop. It sets the index variable before we enter the for loop scope here. It checks this the first time that you enter the for loop and every time that you continue repeating, and then it does this at the end of the for loop. So the first time that you enter here, your index value is 0. It then adds it, and now it's 1. And then it makes sure that index is still less than length. If that's true, then now it adds 1. Sets it to 2, checks if the length is less than 4 or 5 in our case, and it keeps looping through. So one more thing we can do is that since Java 5, there was this concept of what we call enhanced for loops, which are simpler to read. Basically what we can do is we can iterate over the array directly without having to keep track of the index. I'm gonna say for number within the num array, sum equals sum plus number. Now isn't that pretty easy to read? All right, and it results in the same value. This is a really succinct explanation of what the code is doing. For each number within the number array, we take the current value of our sum and we add the number to it and assign it back into the sum. There's even a slightly more shorthand way to do this line, and that is plus equals. Effectively, it's doing the same thing. Let's just run the code to demonstrate that. All of this is doing is it's another shorthand for add the current value of the sum variable to the number and return it back into the sum variable. Now, arrays work more than for just integers. We can also do an array of strings. Same concept of how we initialize them. Now I want to change this to a string array. And now I'm going to do what's called string concatenation, and I'm going to add them together. And now I need to set this to an empty string. This isn't the most efficient way to concatenate strings together, but it shows the purposes enough. Now I'm just going to call this cat, short for concatenate. Let's run this code. All right, very good. So we showed that without having to change all that much, just the type declarations, we were now able to demonstrate that we can iterate over an array of strings and we can concatenate them together and print out the result. Awesome, this is great. One other quick thing I want to mention is if you're visual, you can think of an array kind of as a box. A box has a known size, and once you start putting contents into it, eventually it fills up and you can't put anything else in there. An array is very similar. You can put a known quantity of elements into your box, and as long as you know how big your box is and about how many elements to expect in it, you can use it, and your code can then take elements out of the box. It can look through everything in the box, or it can just pick out one thing. Doesn't really matter. Point being is that arrays are a way to contain a set of the same thing in a known fixed size. And there you have it. Those are the fundamental concepts of how arrays work in Java. If you liked this video, please be sure to hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, hit that subscribe button. Also, if you thought the content was interesting, or if you have any suggestions of things I could do differently or different content I should address, please drop a comment below. Thank you all for watching. Hope you have a great rest of your day, and hope to see you next time. Take care.